Ladies and gentlemen, Morris.
From the Silver Slipper to the Landmark to Vegas World, Morris Bates earned the title of the longest-running Elvis performer in Las Vegas. He was one of the first professional Elvis impersonators in the world and the first to break the act into 50s, 60s, and 70s segments.
Just for a novelty, I said we're going to do a little tribute to Elvis. And I started doing them in the 50s. I never started in the 70s where I performed. But I try to leave as much as I can the character in his dressing room, along with the suits. When I get out of the suits, I get in my clothes and I walk in there. I put a cowboy hat on or whatever I want to be. I leave here and I'm Morris Bates. I see too many people working too hard to try to be Elvis off the stage to walk around. I can't take it because I work so hard on stage to give that image. If I used to work that hard off stage, I'm going to be very tired and I wouldn't have anything left to give the people when I got here if I was trying to walk around and be Elvis in the daytime. Whatever.
You know, Elvis used to say that there's no such thing as a coincidence. And it's no coincidence that more people loved Elvis Presley in the 20th century more than any other figure that has ever lived. It's no coincidence that his voice has been heard around the world more than any person in the history of the world.
But it's one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready, and I go, can't go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything but take me over my blue suede shoe. Well, you can knock me down, step in my face, slander my name all over the place. Well, do anything that you want to do, but not, honey, lay off them shoes. And don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything but take me over my blue suede shoe. Let's go, cat.
Following his 10 years in Las Vegas, Bates moved back to Canada and began working as a specialized victims assistance worker with the Vancouver Police and Native Liaison Society. There, he developed an aversion program called Reality Check for Indigenous People. He continues to inspire youth to take positive chances in life.